Hello, my name is Chad Hart. I'm an extension economist with Iowa State University. And this is an introduction to crop marketing. This is part of a series of videos we have supporting the Iowa Commodity Challenge, a web simulation program that helps producers explore crop marketing in more detail. And today what we're going to discuss is marketing. And when you think about marketing, you know, we tend to think of just to the sale of the commodity. But marketing is a whole series of events and services that are built to create, modify, and transport a product from its initial creation to that final consumption. So there are a lot of steps to the marketing process. Like I say, we typically think of the sale, but you know, it goes into the planning, the production of the product, the inspection, the transportation of that product, the storage, the processing, and then the final sale. So there are a number of steps when we look at the marketing chain. Like I say, we tend to concentrate on the sale because there are so many market participants when we look out there, from the producers who produce the products, the corn, the soybeans, the cattle, the hogs, but to the elevators, the processors, the transport companies, bankers, insurance companies, etc. So the idea is we have a lot of participants that play a part in the marketing channel. They all have different strategies, different objectives that they're trying to meet, and that's what makes marketing so interesting, is that we're pulling together all these different participants, all these different processes within the marketing chain as we go forward. Now, when you look at marketing tools, there are four basic tools that we utilize for crop marketing specifically here. And when you think about more complex marketing strategies, they're basically combinations of these four tools. And through this series of videos, we're going to walk you through what these tools are and how they can be utilized in crop marketing. First and foremost, there's the straight cash sale, where, and this is the one that most of us are used to, this is how roughly two-thirds of commodities are traded today, where basically the producer of the product creates the product, goes to that point of first sale, and then literally sells it for the cash price on that day. Very simple sale. It's sort of like a sale that you would participate in when you go to your local convenience store or like a Walmart or Target, something like that, a cash sale. Beyond that, there's the forward contract. The forward contract is like a cash sale, with the difference being that we're determining when that product will be brought to market some future point in time. So rather than delivering the product today, I may be delivering it a month from now or 2 months from now. But the price is being determined today, and we're willing to pay that cash price today for the product to be delivered in the future. Third marketing tool that we tend to use are what we call commodity futures, which are like forward contracts, but here the difference is that we're talking about not only a delivery sometime in the future, but we're also talking about a delivery point somewhere other than where we are right now. In this case, with our commodities that we're looking at here with the Iowa Commodity Challenge, we're talking about crops. Futures then are delivered in Chicago, and so that's when we talk about what's going on the Chicago Board of Trade or the Chicago Mercantile Exchange. And those are the prices that we tend to hear reported when we're talking about the markets, when you hear about it in the ag media. But again, a futures contract basically says we're going to deliver or could deliver to Chicago at some point in the future. And then finally, we have options. Options in this case are options on the futures contracts that I just talked about here. An option is the right to either buy or sell a futures contract. And what that allows us to do is it allows us to put in price floors or price ceilings depending upon how we utilize the options. And they're a fairly sophisticated tool that we'll talk about in greater detail in a few of these videos for the Iowa Commodity Challenge. Now, when looking at why we're using these marketing tools, we're typically thinking about our pricing targets. And when we're talking about successful marketing, it can be defined in several ways. A lot of people get caught up in trying to capture the highest price. And while that is a great goal to have, it's also a very, if you will, fairly unattainable goal because it's very hard to pick that highest price. The idea is most of us, we would love to be able to hit that lottery ticket. Most of us don't win that lottery ticket. The idea is we tend to miss. And so I like to reframe, if you will, our marketing targets based upon goals that can be realized that mean something to my farm business. First and foremost, you know, if I want to stay in business, I've got to cover my expenses. And so we can look at successful marketing as a marketing such that we're able to cover our cost, continue our operation for the next season or the next year. Because as long as we approach it from a farm business perspective, if we're covering our cost, then we're covering our ability to make it into that next season. Another target we could have, and probably the one that I would argue is the most realistic one, is also the one that really captures the idea of that we're working here at the farm business, is to look at long-term profitability. It's not that each trade needs to be profitable, but as we look over the series of our career, have we obtained profitability in the long run? Have we maintained our business where we can not only maintain it, but grow it as we go forward? And so this is saying, okay, as we look at marketing, it's not that each and every trade needs to be profitable, but as we look at the bulk of the trades that we do through a season, through a decade, through our career, have we achieved that profitable goal to continue to build our farm business? And it's through this series of videos that we're doing here for the Iowa Commodity Challenge that we hope to walk you through these tools, these targetings, in order to reach that goal of maintaining long-term profitability for your farm business. And I want to thank you for your time and spending that you're doing with these videos on the Iowa Commodity Challenge. And I wish you happy marketing. Again, my name is Chad Hart. I'm an extension economist for Iowa State University, working here for the Iowa Commodity Challenge.